Today, I will introduce a new video generation model called OVI. This model can not only generate standard dialogue videos, but can even create various sound effects. Furthermore, it integrates text-to-video and image-to-video generation into a single model. We can see many interesting examples on its official website. For instance, traditional voice-to-video generation.
Enjoy this moment. No matter where it's taking.
The generated videos possess a stronger sense of visual presence and cinematics.
Come here.
In this example, besides the dialogue, we can also hear very clear footsteps. Moreover, it can generate multi-person dialogue.
You always give me extra foam.
That's how I bribe loyal customers.
It can generate multiple languages. For example, the first half of this video uses English, and the second half uses Spanish.
Help them through the grimness of daily life. Da brauchst du natürlich Fantasiebild.
It even supports Korean.
제가 과거의 과장님께 뭔가.
Additionally, we can use this model to generate videos similar to singing.
Come with you. I just.
Of course, you can also use it to generate purely instrumental sounds or ambient sounds. As you will notice in this video, the sound of the guitar and the finger movements are perfectly synchronized. Through these examples, you might conclude that this model is indeed excellent. How to use it? You can visit its GitHub official website. There, we can find a lot of useful information. For example, it was generated by fine-tuning the WAN 2.5B model. There are many ways to use it. For instance, you can use it directly on Hugging Face or on platforms like Wavespace. Note that these options are generally paid. If you want to use it for free, there are also methods available. For example, Kijai is attempting to implement this model within their WAN video extension, though it is currently still in the development phase. You can see an OVI branch, but it hasn't merged into the main branch yet. Besides this, many experts in the open source community have created corresponding extensions. The extension we are using today is called ComfyUI. Later, I will build all the workflows on Running Hub. You can access this platform via Running Hub. Running Hub is an excellent online workspace in the ComfyUI domain because it follows up immediately whenever new technology and extensions appear. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description. This grants you 1,000 free credits plus an additional 100 credits given daily just for logging in. This way, you can experiment with your own workflows. Next, let's look at the installation details. First, we must pay attention to the environment requirements. Since the core of this model integrates the WAN 2.5B model with audio, the overall hardware requirements are quite high. The GPU requirement is 16G to 24G, and it is even recommended to have VAM greater than 32G. CUDA should be version 12 or above, and PyTorch should be version 2.4 or above. You should check these requirements before installation. Next, let's demonstrate the environment check in a Linux environment. You can use the command nvccv to check your CUDA version. Notice that my CUDA version is 12.8. Then we can use piplist to retrieve all installed packages and check the Torch version. Mine is 2.7, which meets the basic requirement of 2.4 or higher. Next is the basic installation. First, we clone the repository, switch to the corresponding directory, and install all dependencies. Now let's see the specific demonstration. First, ensure you enter the ComfyUI custom node directory. Then we clone the repository. This process is very fast. Next, switch to the correct directory and install all dependencies. If the installation process has no errors, you can proceed to the next step. The next step is the model download. Model downloading has two parts. The first part is the automatic download, which includes the main audio model and the main OVI model. However, besides that, we also need to manually download our VA and encoder. We mentioned earlier that the entire model is fine-tuned based on the WAN 2.5B model. Therefore, the VA used is the WAN 2.2 VAE, not the commonly used 2.1 VAE. As for our encoder, it uses the UMT-5 encoder. But be aware, this is slightly different from the traditional UMT-5 used in ComfyUI. This encoder is the same one used in model training. So, I recommend everyone download it. If you have 32G VRAM or more, you can download the BF16 version. If you have 24G or 16G VRAM, you can use the FP8 version. After downloading, we can store them according to this directory structure. You can find our sample workflow in the sample workflow folder. Once the workflow is loaded, it looks like this. The overall structure is very simple. The core component is the OVI video generator. It has configuration options and our prompt settings. Here, the corresponding OVI model is loaded. For example, our main model, I am currently using the FP8 version. You must set this based on your VRAM situation. If you have 24G VRAM, you must select the CPU offload option. For the device, we default to selecting your first graphics card. Below that is our VAE, we select the 1.2.2 VAE here. And here is our encoder, also the FP8 version. Regarding your attention mechanism, you can choose SDPA or Sage Attention if installed, or Auto if you are unsure. Since I have installed Sage Attention, I will select it directly. Further down are our relevant configuration settings. We generally do not adjust the corresponding parameters. Usually, we only set the width and height. However, you should note the explanation regarding the sampling steps. If you require faster sampling speed, 20 to 25 steps should ensure a basic generation quality. If you want a better result, you can use 50 steps for this demonstration. I will use 20 steps for sampling. If you connect a reference image to the first frame image option, it becomes image to video. If you do not connect one, it is text to video. Next, let's run a test. We paste a prompt and generate a video. Let's take a look. Before generating the video, let's briefly explain the prompt. When writing prompts, pay attention to two very interesting marking languages as and as. As stands for start and per s stands for end. This represents the speech spoken by a person. This is a special marker. Additionally, there is a marker called AutoCap. This is for generating sound effects and ambient sounds. If you have special requirements for background sound effects or ambient sounds, you can write them within this marker. For example, here it specifies a clear female voice and outdoor sound effects. You can design the rest of the prompt as you envision. For the audio portion, you can experiment with these two marking languages. Now it is generated. Let's look at the result.
Enjoy this moment, no matter where it's taking.
As you can see, the effect is excellent. If you feel the image quality is not high enough, you can use other text-to-image models to generate the first frame, like I did beforehand. The generation method is simply pasting the prompt into a T2i model, temporarily deleting the dialogue part to get a similar image. Then, we resize it because the resolution used here is 960 by 512. So, we scale it to the corresponding resolution and connect this image. At this point, it becomes image to video. Okay, let's generate it. You can click on the terminal. Note that the information here is quite abundant. For example, regarding the prompt I just generated, you can see a description of the generation mode. It was a pure T2V method, but once you add the image, it becomes the image to video method. Let's look at the generated result.
Enjoy this moment, no matter where it's taking.
The overall motion and human figure are excellent. Now, let's test a multi-person dialogue scenario. I will use the text-to-video format again and remove the image. Let's sample and generate. Now let's look at the generated result.
You always give me extra foam.
That's how I bribe loyal customers.
Next, let's briefly test a singing scenario. We will use the same image. I modified the prompt slightly to say the girl is singing and the content is "Hello everyone." Note there is a marker here specifying what she is singing. Now let's generate it and listen to the effect.
Hello everyone.
Of course, this is not perfectly accurate, but the effect is still quite good. These are the basic OVI examples we demonstrated. Of course, we haven't demonstrated all of its features. For many of you, writing the prompt might be a challenge. You can find two files on its GitHub homepage. These contain some of the prompts it uses. You can refer to these prompts or use them directly to generate corresponding videos. The overall performance of this model is excellent. For example, it can generate audio sound effects, multi-person dialogue, music, and even background sounds. The overall quality of video generation is also very high. Therefore, many people jokingly call it the open source VO-3. What are you waiting for? Give it a try yourself. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.